10 plus 8.
Students can have trouble learning challenging material, but what happens when a teacher has to compete with a loud air conditioner? A team of researchers from the University of Nebraska-Lincoln is trying to answer that question.
Right now we're measuring air velocity, so we have different probes at different heights.
A variety of measurements taken in more than 200 Nebraska classrooms will help determine how the environment affects learning.
The question is whether or not the environmental variables in a classroom affect student achievement.
Project leader Lily Wang is an acoustics expert at the UNL Durham School of Architectural Engineering and Construction. Wang and her colleagues are studying the effects of acoustics, indoor air quality, and lighting on student achievement.
You can find people who've just shown the effects of lighting, or just shown the effects of acoustics, or just of temperature, but no one has actually been able to put together a team that looks at all of them.
Measurements are taken in empty classrooms by a team of students working after school. Test kits deployed in the classroom also collect information during the school day.
That will show us how things are changing over the course of a day. You know, how does the carbon dioxide level change? How do the sound levels change? How is the daylighting in the classroom? Also electric lighting as they turn on and off lights.
This is just a really great experience to see what kind of measurements are necessary to look at the architectural aspects of certain environments.
It's a really cool thing to be a part of.
Data will be analyzed and compared with student performance on standardized tests. Resulting information will be shared with school districts.
That's our goal, is to be able to help school administrators and school designers understand better how to utilize funds to better design school environments.
UNL is one of 7 research groups nationally to be funded by the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency's Healthy Schools Initiative. Researchers hope the project will help take some of the struggle out of learning.